Hello everyone, I'm ExtraCheesy87 and this is Let's Play Trails of Cold Steel 4 Part 107. In the previous video, we completed the second rivalry by facing off against Rutger and then facing off against him again with Reen and Crow and their old Divine Knights. Put him to bed, slurped up his soul milkshake. It was a pretty good scene between him and Fee though. Now it's time to move on to, it seems like we're setting up to fight Arion Road next, which I think is not a good idea. I feel like I'd still the opinion she should be saved for last. Three days, man. I feel like we're going to be cutting it kind of close. Because, like, the only way I could think of it being, like, is, like, if you fight Cedric and Rufus at the same time, but even then, I'm like, I feel like Arion is a tougher threat than that. And plus, in theory, after Reen beats Arion Road, he should be like fucking Omega tier jacked. Thanks for waiting. Are you alright now? Yeah, just cried it all out. If I kept it up any longer, the boss would never let me let it down. I see. I think that's what he really wanted, to be seen off by his beloved daughter, by family. Gaius lived life on his own terms, not as an immortal, bound to a curse, but as a human being. Gotta say, he left on one hell of a high note. Bro. That's when you smack him upside the head. You gotta go, may as well go out with a smile on your face. That's exactly what he did. All we can do is smile back. I'm sure Zeno and Leonidas would say the same. Yeah.
Well, since you've taken on the power of the boss's knight, it only makes sense for us to help you out. Final battle's getting real close. We got a lot of getting ready to do before then.
We'll meet again, Fee. Schwarzer, and the rest of you. Just make sure you survive till then.
End of a legend and the beginning of a new Zephyr. We know how powerful they are. Having them on our side is reassuring. We'll have to show them that we're no pushovers either, but like, we beat them. That's right, we can start by overcoming this next trial, no matter how stacked the odds. It's time to head to Crossbow at last. Place of my lord's rivalry. Yeah, I just don't think fighting Arion's a good idea. Like, I mean, I think it's a good idea, but I just don't think we should fight her second. Duvally? And this will be easy for you. I don't need you to worry about me. The Jaeger King showed us his resolve. It's only fair I do the same. I'll do all I can to persuade my lord to stay with us after the rivalry. The battle itself is another matter. I don't think my lord would look kindly upon such unnecessary consideration. I do believe you're right about that. It seems that our objective is to further protect the Empire, or protect the future of the Empire. Right, our goals actually align in a certain sense. There's probably some hope. Well, if we can't demonstrate our ability to get past this, then it's all moot anyway. Valmar's new evolution, thanks to the Platinum Knight's power, is going to be a big help. Alright, the power received from the Jaeger King. We owe it to him to make the most of it. That we do. Next on our agenda, Crossbow. It seems our team has an update for us. Come on, give me Lloyd. Agate, Shira, you're not Lloyd. And Tovel as well. Yeah, Tovel's cool.
Hey there, everyone.
We heard about the Jaeger King. Good work. Must have been tough.
Yeah, thanks. So how are things going in Crossbow?
Right. There's been some movement that's caught our attention. Word is, there's a giant pillar of light shooting right out of the wetlands.
You mean the same phenomenon as what happened at the Draco Shrine? Right, I can think that the sanctuary's in mood like before. Also, Arwen's accounts stating they saw a shiny knight fly off in that direction. Means there's no doubt she'll be waiting for you there. Lord Boris the Strongest, the Steel Maiden. My lord, the time's finally come. No barrier or similar devices appeared? Right, it seems that only the experimental gargantua class battleship was the one we encountered yesterday. Thank you, Bracers. We know you're busy and appreciate you taking the time to contact us. Eh, that's no big deal. Security seems to be light now, so we're about to head over to confirm things ourselves. Watch your back, okay, Oliver? Make sure to get them there. You got it. Make sure too, until we meet again, Sheriff. So, crossbow, huh? The area on the brink of turning into a battleground once the war begins. Looks like the invasion of Calvert will begin on the Tangram Fortress on the east side. And right before that, we face the biggest hurdle of the war's shadowy underbelly. In any case, we need to prepare ourselves to the maximum extent possible. Right, to stop the Great Twilight and to somehow stop the war. I kindly request that you allow me to join the fight starting today. Nope. Please call me without hesitation if such a need arises. We'll be counting on you. Your wound is only just healed, though. I don't want you overexerting yourself. Sure, but we could really use our abilities in battle. Let's get this party started, kittens. Considering the circumstances, I'd like to depart for Crossbell as soon as possible. However, a number of orders will also arrive, so please do give them a once-over once you have a moment. In the meantime, I'll map out a safe route to Crossbell. Second like this will be our last foray into the western half of Barabonia for a while, so make sure you don't leave anything undone. Right. Okay, I feel like the translation there is you only get to go to Crossbell one more time at the end of the game, so you better enjoy it. The Crossbell, huh? You and the others infiltrated at once, right? I mean, I'm worried about the city, seeing as they have a war brewing out on their doorstep. Green. Be gone. Be gone. Until we make our way to Crossbell, if you want to make any more runs to the surface, we'd like to join you. Your Highness and Elise, I'm not so sure that's... There's still a lot happening in Western Erebonia, and as Toa's representatives, there are matters we must attend to. Like what? They had no intention of taking point, of course, but we can help out with our orders and anything else you might need. We did receive my brother's full approval, for the record. Or could he come with me instead? Tagging along would also allow me to see the current state of the Empire, and I'd really appreciate the escort. You two have really grown up. Alright, fine, but don't ever do it out there. You got it. Alright. So. Here's the question. Do we go ahead and put in characters who we know we're going to use for Aryan Road? Which, I mean, the characters we're going to use for Aryan Road, it's probably going to be Laura, Duvali, Yuna. Maybe Eustace will be forced. I don't know. He'll probably wait for him for Rufus. Other characters that might be forced in an Aryan Road fight? I don't know. Randy? I mean, I'll bring Randy. He may not be forced, though. I'm just trying to think, like, do we want to use different characters and then use them for that section? I think we're just going to kind of use the same characters for an extended period of time, like with Fee and Sarah in them. But definitely Moxius. I promise that this is going to be the era of the Moxer. I'm not a liar. Now, the question is who else to bring? I'm definitely going to bring Randy for Aryan Road. He has to, you know, assert his dominance once again. He may not have Lloyd to combo craft with this time, but, he doesn't need Lloyd. He's grown too powerful. And then, I mean, like, I guess he could bring Sharon? I guess? Situation at Titus Gate and each of the field exercise camps has changed. You can now explore Langodot Canyon North. Elise and Alpha will be accompanying you. As with Toa, they won't participate in direct combat, but they'll provide powerful orders to support you and your party. Now, I remember Elise's was like the evasion and heal, or evasion and TP. I don't remember what Alphen's was. 9 bonding events. Who else got bonding events? How do I check? Yuna, how many damn bond events do you have? I mean, like, in theory, I shouldn't be mad because you, like, were one of my favorite characters in CS3, but, like, I feel like all your bonding events have been kind of ass. Like, they're just boring. So, Yuna, Duvali, Ash. Okay, I'm excited for Ash to see the conclusion to his, you know, search for Merchant Man. Emma. Emma's was pretty good last time. Fee, Elisa, Altina. I liked Fee's first event. I don't even really remember Elisa's. I mean, I kind of vaguely do. The whole issue was like, we can't, don't talk to me anymore. And then Altina's, they've just been kind of boring as well. And Crow's first room is fine, just a little basic. Also, I can't leave. I guess we have to look at our quest first. What all do we got? Alster assistance? I was really supposed to tackle this request, but my plate kind of overfloweth at the moment. You think guys think you can check it out for me? All I know is that Kai and Tilly are having some trouble, with an especially ornery monster over towards Alster. I'm sure they'll be happy to see you again anyhow. Tovel. Tovel, join my party, man. Okay, we will not be doing any combat in this video. Of course not. I have no desire to set everyone up right now. But I'm thinking, like, our main party, like, our main four that we're gonna primarily use, definitely Duvely Machias, because they have not had a chance to shine. Oh, you have Erda? What the hell? Okay, give me that. I don't know what to give you. So we know that the Gloom ability is just two turns of stealth, which is really good. Definitely. And it might be worth equipping back on you just to level it for the time being. I wonder what Scorpio's craft is. I mean, like, I think Scorpio is technically good. It's just something you have to, like, build around. Like, you have to completely build around breaking and probably have Scorpio multiple characters to make it work. Like, I think it's more, like, situation. Like, you have to... Like, it's not as multi-purpose or easy to use as some of the other stuff, which is why I've kind of shied away from it in this game. And I mean, I used it a lot in CS3, so I don't think it's that I'm, like, sleeping on it too much, but... I kind of wouldn't mind leveling it. What are other stuff that we might... I mean, we pretty much got everything. And then Zephyr... I mean, I think Zephyr's good. It's just got, like, it's got big competition. That's kind of what, like, a lot of them feel like. Like, I feel like none of the Master Courts are actually, like, complete trash except for this. This is, like, the only one that's an emblem is. I mean, the extra items doesn't matter to me. And the default effect is kind of useless in combat. So, like, really only emblem and Kaleidio are, like, I think straight up kind of bad. But then some of them, like Zephyr, I think is good, but, you know, there's a lot of other good stuff. Yeah, I don't really know what to give you. I mean, the obvious thing would be, I guess, Gloom Gungor. Like, I give Gungor to everyone. Also, what is this setup? This is garbage. Sharon? Sharon, no wonder you're, like, the most joke boss. You use an attack one? What am I gonna do with these characters, Randy? What are we gonna do with them? How do you have better stats than her without a Master Quartz equip? I mean, you don't get that much strength to your Master Quartz, but still. And I don't really know how I want to use Machias. Because, like... I mean, he's best at, like, a support/tank role. But another... I mean, his most powerful thing is definitely Burst Drive, which I just don't use. So, I mean, we could try and build him around, like, making Burst Drive pop. I just, like, I don't know. I think after, like, CS1, where I used Acceleration Strats so heavily, I'm kind of over that shit. Still. And so I don't really, like, want to use Excel stuff that much. So I don't know. I'm undecided. We'll probably just make him, like, a standard, like, tanky boy, but there is a universe in which we, like, pop, like, Brigand or something on him and let him be the Burst Drive boy. But yeah, let's just start talking to people. Now that our musings are over. Crossbell, it's been a while. Circumstances were different. I have loved reform there again. Sounds like someone's retaking the place, eh, Your Highness? Still remember that time 2 years ago when you charged in that jazz bar and started playing the piano? Or the time when he was on the roof and Dingo knocked him off? I can imagine you doing something like that. Well, what can I say? Life's nothing without a little passion. Speaking of piano, that was the time I played from the restaurant in Bowie's too. Yeah. Got thrown in jail afterwards, but hey, looking back on it now, it was a fun time. I think Tito told us that story. You sure have a talent for getting into trouble. Tell me about it. Gotta say though, I thought I was pretty much locked up on the train last time we were here. I'm looking forward to seeing Crossbell again. Just being able to walk around town in the open again is gonna be pretty sweet. I know the feeling all too well. Being dead is quite inconvenient. Man's got away with words. Head to the Stella Sanctuary. Like I'd ever immediately do that. They should just bop you on the head if you try. They say, nah. We wrote fucking 1,000 pages of dialogue. Go read some of it at least, dear God. Crossbell's up next, huh? Your Zen's operating in Altair these days. Altair's about as west as you can get in Calvert and not too far off from Tangram Fortress. Not for the border being what it is, I'd love to go say hi. You guys say Zen? As in Zen the Immovable from the Scyther School? Oh God, does he have a fanboy? Yeah, it's our Zen. Guessing your old master told you about him? Yeah, more recently I heard he helped out during the orbital shutdown in Lee Burrow. He's supposedly a master of Taito martial arts and one of the most powerful braces out there. That's right, he's even stronger than the other Aarankers like me, Agate, and Shara. Last I heard, he was working with Estelle and the others over on the Calvert side of the border. The way things are, I doubt he'd be able to enter Airbony anytime soon. Obviously. Even A-rank bracers can't move around with complete impunity after all. Just the fact that we have allies we can count on the Republic is something to be grateful for. Yeah, there's that. Freaking disrespect on Zin. I mean, like, they respected Zin's name by saying he's stronger than everyone, but he is also being disrespected by not getting to show up at all. Also, this has got me thinking, how are things between Zin and Killika these days? I think you probably know more about that than me. Zin never tells me anything about his personal life. Well, that's going over my head. That's life, I guess. This is why you have to play the freaking original games, Reen. What's you up to, Gustav? Maintenance? Yeah, the military finance guys and gals have taken plenty on their plates, so I thought I'd take care of that for them. Besides, I might get in charge of the artillery, you never know. Figure I might as well tool around with the equipment and make some tweaks now. Sounds like a good use of your time. You're being combat tactics, but Gustav really lights up when it comes to tasks like this. He's a natural. Gustav. We haven't looked at our notes in a while. The reincarnation of Dreykles. Lessons learned. Man, we're done with Musée. Covering this lost memory seemed to mean a lot to Ash. Aw, with you there. The trainer in Isolation, Laura, learned to accept her weakness. She's ready to take up a sword in defense of who she loves, or those she loves. Mother's will. Emma's mother, Isola, was a wandering way. I don't wonder if they're... I assume they're eventually going to say, like, how she died, like, specifically? I don't know. I feel like it's probably important. Because, I mean, they bring it up enough that it feels like it's, you know, not that she just, like... You know, she probably died doing something important that's going to, you know... have some meaning there. I can't read all these, if I'm being honest. Oh, you guys, you got added, but you didn't get anything filled out? Lovers at last. Toval. Being on the M? What? Alrighty, I don't want to talk to you. I mean, it's not that I don't want to talk to you, it's that, you know, you got a bond of it, and I always say this to the end. I'm not trying to disrespect you or nothing. What you got for me, dude? It's not looking easy for both of them. I just hope they can work together well. Something bothering you, Stark? Greetings, Dr. Reen. Well, Sydney and Kai are currently on the surface to help the main campus. I'm not sure I follow. What kind of help are you talking about here? The issue is that the Durflinger's medicinal stock has been depleted to the point where it's no longer enough. We were asked if we could lend any of ours, but we don't really have that flexibility, you see. But Kai said he can produce some for us as long as he can find the necessary ingredients. Ah, I see. He's amazing with all that kind of stuff. Yeah, he really is. Well, it looks like he needs two different ingredients to do it. You know, the Durflinger are hiding out by what's left of the Southern Field Exercise Camp. For the Kai, if we head over to the main road in the camp's outskirts, we should be able to acquire both. Sydney happened to be around, so he got dragged along. They've gone down together to each look for an ingredient. The main campus about the situation, or heard about the situation, Fritz and Anna both offered to pitch in. Those two are always good help to have. Definitely, but the search doesn't seem to be going well. It might not be appropriate for me to say this, but I'm also concerned about the pairs. Kyrie and Fritz are working together, and Sid and Anna make up the other team, but, I see, they definitely never seen any experience in the field with their current partner. Right, so I guess all we can do is wait for the good news, right? Please, they'll contact us if they need any kind of backup or assistance. True. Fine, we'll go help them. I'm not so sure about that, Stark. Something feels a little off to me. I think I'll go lend them a hand. Oh, would you? That would be certainly a huge help. Definitely, I don't mind at all. I'm free right now, anyway. Where are they searching right now? Kyrie's on Hamel Road and Sydney's on Parm By Road. Thanks again, Instructor. I'll get in touch with both teams as a precaution. Finding Medicine, the classic Trails quest. So what all places got new stuff? So part of St. Arc, that area, part of Farn, Titus Gate, Aaron Village got refreshed. Small amounts of Ordis, a little bit of Raquel, all of Ulster, and part of Leaves. Yeah, I would assume not too. Okay, we're missing a trial chest. Is there another in the Draco Sanctuary? Or another in the Luna Sanctuary? Because I can't think of any of the other locations that would have had one that we didn't check. This says 25, so we're missing 24. So it would be after the Luna Sanctuary. Now, I'm pretty sure we checked this area with Moonlands, right? Yeah, I'm not seeing any. And there wouldn't be any in the altar. There's somewhere that we only just had access to after doing the Luna Shrine. The main thing is, where was it? Oros Coastal Road? This area was new? Was there a chest around here that I missed? Ah, there was. Okay. Let's go ahead and at least unlock it. And we'll pick up this one while we're here. And by pick it up, I mean cut it in half. Water's the fifth, no! If only we had that in the previous sections, we would have... I mean, we still won all the boss fights on our first try, but like, we would have maybe won them faster! Yeah, Reen, Elisa, Fee, and Eusis. Can I open the members of the chest? Fine. That's probably an upgrade to Elisa's? Who? Well, one of Reen's, like Raging Fire still needs to be upgraded, and Gold Dragon can still be upgraded? And Divine Song? Of these, I think... Honestly, I guess Gold Dragon probably needs it the most. I don't know, I feel like Gold Dragon's just... Especially now that I know it's not a flat crit increase like I thought it was, it's actually a lot, like, not as good. That or just the crit bugged out for some reason on Reen. Because he does have 60 crit, so there's no reason he shouldn't have crit when Infernal Gale was up or Infernal Hunt. Yeah, it's basically just Reen. Elisa's hasn't been upgraded, I'm pretty sure, yeah. And then you still need to be upgraded. There's probably, what, 30 chests then? This is 25, we've done up to 25. All right, we'll do that at a later date. Take me back to the ship. No hot springs action this time. Well, there may be something actually at the actual hot springs.
I feel revitalized.
No comment. At least taking a break by yourself. Yes, the operations are done for the moment. I just have a little bit of work left. Work? Yes, actually it has something to do with you. I'll be able to tell you about it soon. I'm curious, but I'll leave it for now. Don't push yourself too hard. I just have a little bit of work left. I'll be able to tell you soon. Please just be patient a little while longer. It's not going to be like you're not like looking into the laws of Erebonia to see if you can marry your brother, are you? Interesting. Pretty good, right? My latest recipe, blue cheese soup. I've reduced it to a whole lot to really bring out the ingredients' essential flavors. Like the mold. Listen, I got nothing against blue cheese in itself. But getting in such a concentrated form is a little overwhelming. Extra real punch, that's for sure. Knew you guys would like it. Took a lot of work, but knowing it measures up to Class 7's high standards makes it all worth it. That's absolutely not what I said? I'm getting some serious deja vu here. Now, eat it all up, or else palm me, Gaius. Fermented foods are a big part of Nord cuisine, but I've never encountered anything with a smell this pungent. Dude, you can't knock it out until you try it. I'll just have to let my taste buds be the judge over my nose. Another, let me ask, do you play Pom Party, Reen? Oh, don't we? Yeah, don't tell me you do too. I wouldn't expect you to be the type to get into that sort of thing. Well, I caught my eye while I was toying around with the old computer on the Merkaba. Care to play a round or two with me when you get some spare time? Sure, that'd be fun. Begin to perish.
Go easy on me.
Nope. You will never win. You cannot defeat me, traveler. My palms are too strong for you. They're not even fit for a beast, much less a dominion such as yourself. Actually, that does go there. I, of course, knew that. I think I may have mentioned this before, that I'm possibly the greatest to have ever palmed it. I don't know where this goes. Gaius, why do you have so many points? I feel like I was doing so good. And then I look over and he's fucking palmed it, man. Nah, we're fine. Look how... save me? I don't know what to do with this. Alright. You momentarily dazed me. You hit me with your absolute delay, and like, okay, you got me for a brief microsecond. You had me, but it takes more than that to defeat the Pawn Master. I beat Tio in Azure pretty easily, might I add. Now, when I say pretty easily, what do I mean? I mean, I'm pretty sure I had to, like, actually stop talking because she, like, was kicking my ass, but it only took a few attempts. I'm fine. I'm fucking toasted, my dude. I mean, I'm... There is no universe in which I would ever fail. I don't want this. You see, the thing is that I don't want this. Gaius is, like, too good. I mean, he's a fair challenger to the throne of Ultimate Pong, but he himself could never defeat moi. Bro, I got no fucking points.
I had the wind at my back.
Yes, yeah, I just wanted to hear his victory line.
Go easy on me.
That's not what you're supposed to do. I mean, it's like when I make a mistake, it's even worse because I get like stun locked by it, by like thinking of what to say about my very obvious fuck up. Bro, he's got so many fucking points. What the hell? I mean, look at that. That you think you're... That you wish you were as good as I am. You see how pong I am? You cannot defeat me? Gaius? You hear that? It's the sound of your imminent defeat. Goodbye. Sir, you took no damage? Nah, you're dead. Bro, look at your board. You should be deceased. What the hell? You got the greatest combo the world's ever seen? What the fuck? Oh god. No. You can't kill me. Don't kill me yet. Don't kill me yet. You thought you could palm me? You come to me on the day of my palm and embarrass me like that by trying to usurp my throne? You thought I was dead. You thought I was dead. You're like already like fucking halfway at the comet's heights up. Oh wow, look at him fucking losing to Gaius twice. I don't want this. This is not red. I mean, all according to the map. Bro, you have no damage taken. Nah, because then the blue drops, then that drops, then this drops. And then the fucking freshest mixtape drops. You don't even know how to deal with it. The hot fire, we're coming. Crimson Slash, Reen's hot new album. No, bro, you just fucking die, man. Okay. Everyone shut up. Everyone be quiet. Stop talking. I don't want this. I don't want this either. Sometimes you gotta go for the kill, man. Bro. Nah. You may be thinking, aren't you putting them all in the wrong spot? Yes! I am! Thank you for noticing! I don't know what you just did, but like, stop. This is oh my god, dude. It's the greatest palm battle the world's ever seen. It's like the fucking Septurions, man. It's the unmovable force versus fucking the unbreakable object. Except I'm the breakable object. Like, I look over, and I'm like, oh, man, we got CP. This man's toast. And then I look over, and his fucking board is completely clear. It really just makes you think. It makes you think about a lot of things. Like, you know, the duality of man and whatnot. About, like, it makes you ask questions like, why do we palm? Like, we have so many things we could be doing, yet here we are palming. And I just think there's something beautiful in that. In the fact that you motherfucker,
I had the wind at my back.
You saw me pull the S-Craft screen up, man. You saw me pull it up. I had 800 CP. I started fucking talking about a bunch of nonsense.
Go easy on me.
And now you're like, oh, okay. Now I can type my deleted comment about how you lost to Gaius twice. I gotta like fucking retype the whole thing again. I'm on to you. Straw person I made up. I'm on to you. Nah, what if I just, like, kept flooding you with, like, small ults? What if you just, like, we're destroyed. Reduced to ashes? And I flooded your board? To the degree that you just, like, you didn't even know what to do. You're like, oh my god, I can't palm it? He's palmed it so freaking hard on me? I mean, you may be thinking, it kind of looks like the strategy is backfiring and you have no CP and his board is the exact same as you, yet you have no CP and he has 500 and he's going to send you to the Shadow Realm in a second. Especially since you're not getting the greens that you want. Nah.
I had the wind at my back.
See, now you have to delete your comment again and be like, why, you lost to Gaius 3 times.
Go easy on me.
I mean, we really should have won that second attempt. That's not where that goes, by the way. I think I just have to, like, shut up for reals this time. Like, actually kind of shut up. But also, like, I don't want to shut up. I like talking. You may have surmised this. My master plan. It has come into play. Like, really the issue is that, like, my S-crafts are so delayed and his aren't. It's basically just he's just a dirty lowdown cheater. Bro, you're dead. You're dead. I'm looking at your board. You're fucking toasted. How are you not dead? How did you get the greatest combo in history? I'm just asking questions, you know? And isn't that really what we're all doing as we go through life? We're all just asking questions about, like, why are we here? And stuff like
well
that.
Played.
I'm here to fucking win. See, if you don't lose 3 times, you don't get the maximum bond events points. And if you don't actually lose to Gaius 3 times there, then you won't get the proper amount of bond points. And you can't max him out and see his secret scene where he turns Reen into a squire and they go off in adventures in Nord and the secret ending. So, yeah, it was all planned. Yeah, you probably didn't even know about that. Nobody's ever seen it before, actually. You know, I just got a hot tip of my mind's eye about it. It's gonna be a fucking first ever when we beat this game in about 100 more videos. Hunter 4 military combat maneuver 22 plunging slice. How else to improve this attack? Have you tried plunging harder? This is the other one giving me trouble. Why the hell is it so difficult? Like I've said a million times, you're overthinking things, Wayne. I'm just recreating how a move looks on the outside. You need to grasp the logic behind it. You need to plunge. And I'm not that I'm in a position to offer much advice. Jessica Wayne, hey, getting a bit of training in? Instructor Reen. We are, in a certain sense. I asked Jessica to observe me right now. Even though I know she wants to focus on her own training. I'm sorry, Jessica, I'm being selfish. I don't mind at all. In fact, observing your movements is good for my own training. It gives me another approach. Sorry I can't offer better advice. The Schleiden School does have its share of fencing techniques, but overall it's primarily focused on spears. Any help or advice I share just ends up being more conceptual than anything concrete. Oh, it's incredibly helpful. It's proving to be a good reference for my improvement. The way things are for me right now, it's not so much who's giving me instruction or advice. The battle with myself. I must overcome my own limits. Oh, overcoming limits, eh? If only we could find some sort of pool. I won't keep you any longer, Jessica. You really should focus on your own training. I appreciate all the help. And you don't need to worry about me, Instructor Reen, I promise. Wayne? He does make some good points, but I would like to tie in Jessica's development too, seeing that she's here and all. Maybe I should call in the girls then. Alright, so I have an interesting proposal for the two of you. In the end, there's no better form of training than sparring. So if we can find a way to make your training more meaningful, just leave it up to me. Can I get the two of you to wait here a moment? Instructor Reen? Is he... How the hell did I wind up here? You grumbled, Duvely, but you were kind enough to help out in the end, were you not? I just thought it'd be good to get some exercise in. I'm just here for my benefit, that's all. Instructor Reen, what's... Laura S. Arsaden, Dubly the Swift. Does this mean you're going to have a spar? You got it. You know, why ain't I gonna fight at the team? That's... It's okay, I haven't given them quartz yet. I finally have the honor of seeing your sliding school techniques from up close, Jessica. One of my dreams have come true, thanks to you to agreeing to be involved. What's this arrangement, Instructor Reen? The 104 military combat fencing techniques adopt the forms of the Arsaden and Vander styles. Indubitably sword techniques, the base of which you learned from the Steel Maiden, share many points in common with the Arsaden style. You'll find much more to learn from them than my 8 Leaves 1 Blade style. And the same can be said of Jessica Schleiden school techniques, of course. That's exactly right. That makes sense. This is probably an ideal type of training for us. Seems like a real challenge. That just means it's truly worth doing. Let's get started. I won't be going easy on either of you. Nor I. I want to see both of you reach new heights. It'll be the groundwork for your future development. Yes, ma'am. Understood.
Now draw
but
your
I don't
weapons.
Want to be Wayne
Show us
or
the strength
Jessica.
That dwells within you.
It's okay. Jessica beat Reen.
No.
Insight looking kind of fresh. Insight looking... some might say it's looking a little mighty fresh. Yeah, you tell him.
You're mine!
You're mine? Tell him, Cedric.
There!
I mean, it helps if, like, one of our characters doesn't get instantly one-shot. Because my insight doesn't fucking do anything.
Now drop!
You're mine! You're mine!
No!
Hey, yo, Jessica, what up? You ever thought about, I don't know, not fucking dying? How the hell is he dodging more than you?
Yes, this is it!
Bro, who made this?
No!
Joke's on you, I'll just kill myself.
Now...
Now!
Too slow!
My insight?
What? Guess this is it!
Now...
Or mine!
No!
She has yet to fucking dodge.
Guess this is it!
Now...
There we go.
It's off balance!
And then he just gets one shot instead? Oh my god, we can play the fucking video game. Holy shit. I don't even know what to do, man. I don't even know how to progress from here. Why do you have regular curio? What is your problem? Are you okay? And we might still die here.
No.
You did 3k plus a...
No.
I'm losing my damn mind.
Strike! Assist me!
Under...
Yes, this is it!
Now... Gotcha! Strike!
Yes,
like, just don't
it.
Give them link attacks.
Take this! No! Now...
You're mine! You're mine!
Can you at least... Okay, you don't resist stat down, so there's no RNG in that aspect.
Gotcha.
Now... lowering stat down... not that great. You pretty much have to use this shit.
I'll withstand anything! Ha!
It's not that it, like, really fucking does anything.
Now!
Because link attacks are a fun mechanic. They're really good. I'm glad they're in the video game.
Now!
I love RNG.
Or mine! Or mine!
Gotcha! Take this!
Oh my god. No. Why is your defense so bad?
Guess this is it.
Now.
Or mine!
I mean, Insight's not fucking doing anything. You just have to, like, hope and pray you don't fucking die.
Yes, this is it!
No!
Now!
Open it!
What? Yes, this is it!
Now!
Yeah, gotcha! No. Gotcha!
Alright, that's our best start ever. And you're still getting just absolutely fucking eviscerated?
No.
As you
take this.
Like, you don't do anything, sir. Like, have you thought about the fact that you don't fucking do anything?
No!
Like, can we discuss the fact that you're fucking garbage? Like, what do you want from me?
Yes, this is it.
Gotcha.
No.
Yeah, gotcha. Gotcha.
I mean, it's like, if you don't get two evades, at least just fucking uninstall. Uninstall immediately. Please don't die.
An opening.
Oh my god!
Ha! Or mine!
No! Take this!
Yes, this is it!
Why would you not give her at least two turns of insight?
Gotcha! Gotcha!
Or at the very least, like, make it so it's a guaranteed freeze or something. Like, it's so RNG dependent. It sucks.
Or mine!
I mean, none of your stuff's magic. It shouldn't be.
Gotcha.
All right, we can actually finally play the video game.
Or mine! Or mine!
Gotcha.
What a concept.
Or mine!
Strike!
Opening! As you...
Or mine!
I mean, well, I think we're pretty much, like, fine now. Yeah, the speed down sucks.
Gotcha!
Better if they had, like, some orders or something. I mean, I get why they don't have orders, but, like, it'd be fucking nice if they did. Okay, you can't spam your mana too much because you have none. I feel like it's like actual garbage.
I'll withstand anything! Ha! Or mine!
It seems like we're really based on like just vengeance procs.
Or mine!
Now! Assist me!
Under
Or mine!
Got you!
Okay, do you have any way to like buff speed? Man? How's defense looking? Defense still good.
There! Or mine!
Now!
An opening!
Got you!
Okay, defense. We do need to re-up it.
It's off balance!
Vengeance? You're mine?
Or mine!
Got you!
You see, the thing is, you're mine. You may have you heard about this before?
There!
Now, assist me.
Yo, Jessica, what about you? Why don't you fucking pretend Wayne? Balance. Wayne out here hitting for 16k, carrying your ass. I mean, you're doing good in your own with the strength debuffs, but like,
I'll withstand anything. Ha!
Well then,
are you out of your fucking mind? I mean, this shouldn't hurt at all, but like, it didn't do one damage.
Behold,
my strength, it's very sick.
Got you! Now!
An opening!
You're mine!
Oh, we should have rushed. There's no reason not to rush.
You're mine!
Oh god, you didn't debuff her.
Impressively
it's just
done.
Laura. And as you may or may not have possibly heard, have you heard about how you're mine?
There!
You hear about this shit?
Got you.
You're mine!
It's just the beginning. It's so unbelievable RNG hell.
Well done. I'm impressed.
That's enough. I think we just about made it. Right, but we were at our limits there. You both kept up marvelously. I suppose you can say that. That was pretty brilliant, you two. I hope you both feel like you got a lot out of this. I did, that was a great help. It was nice being able to identify areas that needed improvement. Yeah, like fucking, have you heard about insight and actually evading? I mean, you do well with it, Jessica. Also, could you unlock an ability called Vengeance so you could actually do some damage? I must say, the stiffness I felt before the match has completely disappeared. Yeah, I could tell just by watching. I feel like you unconsciously absorbed Laura and Dubley's techniques, and even Jessica's too. In any case, looks like repetitive training might actually be a counterproductive approach for you. I understand the struggle, but I mean to let the tension fade from your shoulders is actually quite difficult. Sometimes you simply must swing recklessly without giving much thought to anything in particular. Laura, need I remind you, your sword, kinda big, could easily fucking hit someone and chop their head off? You know? Imagine you're just like chilling in combat next to Laura, you're grouped up for buffs, and then she just lets a swing go wide, cuts your head off. Thank you, Laura. I'll keep that in mind. You also need to rely on those around you. Take a look around, and you'll find yourself surrounded by many capable warriors. It'd be a crime to seek their advice. Yes, alright, I know what I said. Shut up. What are you looking at? Don't give me that who's talking face. I was actually thinking the opposite. Agreed, I was just thinking about how you've changed quite a bit. I don't know what you're talking about. It's a bit cute, too. I agree. Anyhow, you've both given me some invaluable experience here. Thank you. Alright, I'll fetch you a Sufner for the drill. Are we set up in the slightest? We can wait and do that later. I actually find it quite difficult to avoid thinking about how to move, but if something's like swinging recklessly, I get the feeling that I might be able to manage. Though that being said, I should take care not to get caught up in doing things that way. Also, need I remind you that you're mine. We'll stay here a while longer to cool down. I feel like I learned a lot from that match. You did a good deed today, Enchantarine. Thank you. Fermented foods are a big part of Nord cuisine, but I've never encountered anything with a smell this pungent. Still, you can't knock it out until you try it. I'll just have to let my taste buds be the judge of my nose. Fuck that. If something smells bad, I can't fucking enjoy it. I mean, that's like pretty common, but like smell, look as well. I can kind of ignore look a bit more than smell, but I'm definitely like easily grossed out by stuff. Since I gained a taste for alcohol, I've started to like blue cheese to an extent too. Even then, the soup. I knew a person of a certain taste like yourself would enjoy it.
You've got good taste. Come again.
Anyone else around here? Just you? Okay, we'll probably go ahead and call it here soon. We don't really have time to finish talking to everyone in the Courageous. Hello, Dorothy? Please, talk to me? Instructor Rima, were you eavesdropping in our girly conversation, you naughty man? I mean, not really eavesdropping, we kind of just like walked up and announced ourselves. I was just passing by, don't get any weird ideas. I can pretty much imagine what kind of conversation this is anyway. The idea of reimagining our conversation is a joy in and of itself. I would certainly like to hear what exactly it is you think you're talking about in explicit detail, please. How much you're freaking... I mean, if you're talking about it in private, I don't have a problem. It's just when you talk about it in front of me. I mean, I was just thinking of anything specific, just a general impression. I never imagined the princess would have such an encyclopedic knowledge of my favorite genre. It's quite an honor, really. I'd love to take the opportunity to talk about this and that, or oh, and even that. It seems I've gotten carried away, I see, and I should probably try and keep myself more composed in mixed company. Good luck with that. I heard that Tatiana got Dorothy's autograph at the Summer Festival in Heimdall. I was in LA, but I also got the book I bought signed. This is now an Egret family, and by proxy, a Kyan family heirloom. Yeah, I don't think it works that way. Dorothy has such an impressive imagination. I'm never disappointed by our chats. Still, I really should have brought my own book along like Muse did. You really haven't changed a bit, Your Highness. I mean, okay. I do think it's kind of weird that, like, every female character seems to be into, like, you know, boy-on-boy shit, yet the series itself is, like, absolutely not. That cannot exist. No way. Are you fucking crazy? You sound like you're discussing something important.
Hey, we were just talking about a fan letter I got from a patient at St. Ursula.
I told you about it before, right? The girl who loves the radio dramas? Oh, that's right. You mentioned that she'd been in the hospital for a long time now. I don't think of it. I think Monk might have mentioned her letters, too. That's her. Her name's Nina. Well, Nina enjoyed last week's episode so much that she wanted to write in and tell the station how much she enjoyed it.
Indirect feedback from fans like this is the greatest joy a director could experience. It's so heartwarming. So humbling. Must be hard to be stuck in the hospital, though. Especially as a kid. I don't know. Maybe I can write her back and let her know that I'm rooting for her. And then break her out on my own as Monk, Ace Detective.
What? Really? That'd be wonderful. I know she'd be thrilled to hear from you. Thank you so much, Monk.
Don't mention it. Besides, it's also give me the chance to tell her about the special episode we've got coming up.
There it is.
The episode where the legendary Monk beats Noon easily because he's the greatest and Noon sucks.
I'm a little mortified at the idea she might hear me on the radio, but if it'll make her feel better.
Don't worry, Reen, it's just one little letter. Besides, everyone's gonna be tuning in anyway once our promos start ramping up.
Yep, ready to call in a hole and die right now. I was just writing a letter to Nina. I thought I'd give it to her along with the one from Monk. She loves that show so much, it's gonna blow her mind getting a message from the director herself. Well, wait until, you know, Reen shows up.
Station's been sending in some incredible listener letters. It's really inspiring. Coming from a serious illness like that must be quite the ordeal. May I should write back some words of encouragement.
Alright, we'll go ahead and call it here, and next time we will finish up talking to everybody on the Well, let's look at the deck. Many people on the deck. Okay, nobody's on the deck that we can talk to. Ash, can you be rid of your Mona? I don't know. I mean, like, you were kind of important in the fight, but you didn't, like, You didn't really wow me. Now, to be fair, you were assigned to a support position, which makes it hard for you to, like, wow me. It's easier to stand out when you're, like, the main DPS. But honestly, I don't think you're free just yet, Ash. I think you have to keep the Mona for a little while longer. Yeah, we'll call it here. Next time, we will finish talking to everybody on the Courageous and then head out to our other area. It seems like there's not too much talking, which makes sense because I'm assuming we'll have our crossbell section. You know, once we decide to head out. And there'll be plenty of people to talk to in the old crossbell. I'm MasterTreezy87. Stay tuned for the next part. And bye, guys.